Good morning students, today we are going to study the subject English of 6th standard and the first chapter is Who Did Patrick's Homework? In this chapter we are going to study how Patrick finds his way to complete his homework because he is also the one who do not like to do his homework by his own as many of us. So in this chapter I am going to tell you and explain you how he is finding different ways to complete his homework by the end of the year. And how he comes out of it as a good child.
Chapter 1, Who Did Patrick's Homework? Now I'll read and explain you the chapter. Patrick never did homework, too boring he said. He played hockey and basketball and Nintendo instead. His teachers told him, Patrick, do your homework or you won't learn a thing. And it's true. Sometimes he did feel like an ignoramus. But what could he do? He hated homework. Now Patrick was a child who hated to do his homework by his own. So instead of doing his homework, he used to play hockey, basketball and Nintendo. Nintendo means a video game. His teachers always told him to do his homework or he won't understand or learn a thing in the class. And he also did feel sometimes, yes, it's true. But still he ignored because he hated to do his homework. Then one day he found his cat playing with a doll and he grabbed it away. To his surprise, it wasn't a doll at all, but a man of the tiniest size. He had a little wool shirt with old-fashioned breeches and a high tall hat much like a witch's. He yelled, "Save me, don't give me back to that cat. I'll grant you a wish, I promise you that." Now when he saw that his cat is playing with a doll, he went and grabbed it. But for his surprise, it wasn't a doll. It was a man of a very tiniest size. The description of a man is like, he's wearing a wool shirt with old-fashioned breeches. Breeches means kind of a shirt and a trouser which is wearing together. And a high tall hat like a witch's. Witch's is a character and the tall was matching to that character. The man shouted to Patrick, "Save him. That don't give him back to that cat and he will grant him a wish and he is promising him that." Now you will find there is a rhyming sounds and rhyming words in this chapter. It's just to make the chapter interesting. Patrick couldn't believe how lucky he was. Here was the answer to all of his problems. So he said, "Only if you do all my homework till the end of the semester, that's 35 days. If you do a good enough job, I could get A's." Now Patrick couldn't believe that how lucky he got because he was finding a solution how to do his homework. And this man appeared and the man is telling him that he will grant him a wish. So he agreed to that man, saved him and put a condition in forward. I told that man, "I will save you only if he will do his homework. That is for the whole semester till the 35 days because he also wanted to get A's. The little man face wrinkled like a dishcloth thrown in the hamper. He kicked his leg and doubled his fist and he grimaced and scowled and pursued his lips. "Oh, I am cursed, but I'll do it." Now he had different expression in his face and showing disgust and anger and disapproval. Because he never thought he will get such kind of a condition. He thought he was cursed actually. But anyhow, he wanted to save himself from the cat. So he agreed and he told he will do it. And true to his words, the little elf began to do Patrick's homework. Except there was one glitch. The elf didn't always know what to do and he needed help. Help me," he'd say. And Patrick would have to help in whatever way. Now he agreed to do his work as he promised. But the problem was the elf did not know always what to do. Elf means a small man. Now he always wanted help. So whenever he got stuck by doing Patrick's homework, he would shout, "Help me, help me." And whatever it happens, Patrick have to help him to complete his homework. I don't know this word, The elf squeaked while reading Patrick's homework. Get me a dictionary. Know what's even better. Look up the word and sound it out by each letter. Now when the elf was doing his homework, there was words which was unfamiliar to him. So as soon as he didn't know the word, he used to shout out to Patrick. And he told Patrick to give him a dictionary. And then he thought, what better when Patrick would look up the word and search for the letters and tell him loudly. When it came to Max, Patrick was out of luck. What are timetables? The elf shrieked. Shrieked means with a high pitch, he cried. What is the meaning of timetables? Because the elf wasn't aware of Max's subject. And addition and subtraction and division and fraction. Here, sit down beside me. You simply must guide me. Elves know nothing of human history. To them, it's a mystery. So the little elf, already a shouter, just got louder. Go to the library. I need books. More and more books. And you can help me read them too. Now, these elves did not want these max or subtraction, addition, division, fractions in their life. So he was out of mind and knowledge of all this. So he told Patrick to just simply sit beside him and to guide him. He even didn't know about anything about human history. It was like a mystery for him. So elf shouted even louder and told Patrick to go to library and get some books and read it and help him how to read them too. As a matter of fact, every day in every way the little elf was a nag. Patrick was working harder than ever and was it a drag. He was staying up nights, had never felt so weary, was going to school with his puffed eyes and blurry. Now Patrick actually was working more harder than doing his homework by himself. Because elf was becoming a nag. Nag means someone who troubles you each and every moment and complaining you again and again. Because the elf was running out of the knowledge of different subjects. So anyhow, Patrick had to help him by bringing all the books and reading them out by himself and then to explain it to the nag. So he used to stay up to the whole nights and his eyes used to get puffed and blurry. Finally, the last day of school arrived and the elf was free to go. As for homework, there was no more. So he quietly and slyly slipped out the back door. Now it was finally the last day and the homework was all finished. So the elf was free to go because there was no more homework left. So he quietly and slyly means secretively slipped out of the back door. Patrick got his A's. His classmates were amazed. His teachers smiled and were full of praise. And his parents, they wondered what had happened to Patrick. He was now the model kid. Cleaned his room, did his chores, was cheerful, never rude, like he had developed a whole new attitude. Now finally Patrick got his grade A's. And all his classmates were surprised and amazed. Even his teachers smiled and it was full of praise for him. And his parents was in a question mark. Why? Because they got a little surprised and amazed that what happened to Patrick immediately. They wondered how had he got all the A's in his section. Now Patrick had become a model kid. He always cleaned his room, did his chores. Chores means the everyday doing work. And was a very cheerful child, never rude, and like he developed a whole new attitude because he had done a lot of work, so it changes whole of his attitude. You see, in the end, Patrick still thought he made the tiny man do all his homework. But I'll share a secret, just between you and me, it wasn't the elf, Patrick had done it himself. Still, Patrick believed that he made the tiny man do all his homework. But he never realized that by doing his homework by himself, because the elf was not that knowledgeable. Patrick had to refer the books, tell him, write, read, and each and everything what he was doing by himself. and this is how he himself has completed his homework, but he is not realizing it. So he still thought that that man, little tiny man, did the homework. But the truth is, by helping that little tiny man, it was Patrick himself who did his homework. So this is how we finish the chapter and explanation. The author of this chapter is Carol Moore. So now you also read the chapter again and listen to the explanation properly.
So students, we have finished with the first chapter, that is, who did Patrick's homework. We have read the chapter, understand the chapter. Now you have to read it again and understand it more. Now the question answers and the exercise of the chapter will be given you in the description box. So you must go and verify it and refer it. And also the link of this chapter will be given to you. So kindly go through the chapter once again and write down the question answers and the exercises in your notebook. Thank you.